So there's a new bill in Denmark being proposed where they want to make it so you have to, give a political official a handshake before you become a naturalized citizen. And this doesn't seem like a very big deal. Like most people could easily do this. Like, okay, or whatever, I'll shake his hand. But obviously to Muslims, this is discriminatory, and they're all complaining like, oh, this is anti-Islam and Islamophobic, because like women, I'm guessing, I don't know, maybe the women can't touch men's hands or something because they're it's a stupid religion. But nonetheless, they're all up in arms about this in Denmark, and they're like, well, we're not going to become citizens if you don't change this law. And it's like, good, this is exactly what we want. And it's like other countries should be adopting laws like this, and it would be a lot easier to adopt laws like this instead of one that's like no Muslims allowed, right? That one's going to be a little bit harder of a sell, but you could legitimately, create laws to, ban burqas or face coverings in public. That one, we are trying to do, or they're trying to do in Quebec, but they can try to do it other places. And another thing that we could do is we could ban circumcision. Now, a lot of people are, don't want to do that, but this, first of all, it's not necessary. There are plenty of complications that can arise, and a good example of this is just the other day in my city of Winnipeg. There was this guy who did 18 circumcisions, and of those 18, six or seven of these people went to the emergency room. He told the parents not to tell them that he did it because he never really performed them before. One of the kids, he pretty much cut off the tip of their dick. Their dick's never gonna be the same. He botched a bunch of the other ones, and like this fucking Muslim guy. Once again, where's the story? But it was two boys almost bled to death in botched circumcision by Manitoba doctors. So Dr. Ijaz Ahmad, now suspended for only like 5 months, they suspended him for two. So he's going to start, working again very soon, cutting off the ends of other kids' dicks and potentially putting them in fucking, into the hospital, right? So it's like, these are things that we could do to keep certain people out of our country. And if you're all right, then hey, that keeps out Jews as well. So, there's a bonus once again. But, we need to start implementing laws like that. And first of all, circumcision should be illegal anyways, that if it's performed on childs that cannot consent, right? We don't need to do it. It's not necessary. A lot of people are like, oh, if you do it, it's gonna prevent again HIV and AIDS and some other bullshit. But it's like, you're just a fucking idiot. And the women that are like, well, I prefer that and I want men to do that, you're also a fucking whore, and you should really rethink what you think and what you believe, because you're legitimately saying that you want the tips of little boys' dicks cut off because you like the look of it better. You want these kids to be assaulted when they're little fucking children, and they can't do anything about it because aesthetically you'd like to see it. So, women have, you need to take some ownership of that as well. But, men, women, like, we don't need to do it. We don't need to circumcise w women. We don't need to circumcise men. And, like I said, it's not necessary, etc. Lots of complications can arise, and people can say, oh, well, complications rise if you keep it. But hey, when you're an adult, you can easily just cut it off, trim it off when a problem does arise. They're acting like, oh, but when you're older, your arms are broken and you're a retard and you can't go see a doctor to perform a fucking surgery, right? It's like all the it's only when you're a baby that it makes perfect sense, because oh, you don't feel it, you don't remember it. But just because you don't remember the pain doesn't mean that it doesn't have some type of psychological effect on you, right? If I go and I punch a baby in the face, he may not remember it, right? But he may still react in the future to that, or might have some type of problem developed from that later on, because, you know, he felt this type of massive amounts of physical pain, you know, and, you know, who knows what type of, I don't know, hyperaggression can result from, you know, inflicting damage on little children when they are younger. But I'm getting off track, but if people can get over that, because that one is a very contentious topic for some people, for some reason, where it's like, hey, just don't cut off the tips of their dicks without consent. All these people, feminists, women, they're all for consent, but when it comes to a man and babies, well, they don't need consent. They're not going to remember it. I like the look of it, right? But if we can get over that, we can ban it, and people say, oh, if you ban it, people will still do it. Yeah, that's true. People still do FGM and all this shit, but or female circumcision. But a lot of the reasons they do that is because nobody is prosecuting these people. Nobody's putting them in jail. And that you could easily remedy, okay? You could easily remedy that, easily start putting people in jail for that, putting them away for a very, very long time, because it's, you know, assaulting children. You could put them away for years potentially for that. And if it's your religion and that's how you do things, tough fucking luck. If you don't like it, go back to your fucking country, right? And then you can go and snip the dicks and not shake people's hands and wear burqas in public and do whatever you want. But in our country, you gotta follow these basic rules, you know? Keep your face visible, so then if you commit crimes, we can later on identify you, right? If your face is always covered, you know, and you can do it, nobody else can. Yeah, you walk into a bank, you do all these crimes, and then now it's gonna be that much more difficult to fucking talk to you or find you. And then, you know, not shaking people's hands. Like, come on, you're in civilized fucking society. You can touch other people, shake their hands. And if you can't, if you're not allowed to because you're a woman, then it's like, you know, your culture is obviously not compatible with ours. And you have no reason to be in the country to begin with. So you may as well just go now and make it easier on yourself for the future, because eventually people are going to get pissed off, fed up with all of the changes that are going on in their country, and they're going to kick people out violently at that point. So to avoid this type of violence, we need to make laws now to, you know, basic shit like that, like what the Danes are doing, shaking a politician's hand. And then if they're like, fine, we just won't get our citizenship, we'll just stay here. Well, they're not citizens, so now you can use force against them to forcefully kick them the fuck out of your country, right? So we're just making more options for ourselves. But that's all I pretty much had to say. If you like my content, subscribe and have a good day. See ya.